Love me, say that you love me. It's me, it's your old friend Dan Amrick. I'm the community developer on behalf of Rocksmith, and you have stumbled upon the Rocksmith live stream for this week. What we do every week here from Studio San Francisco in the beautiful city by the bay is we play the songs that we've put into Rocksmith this week as optional paid DLC. So if you are a fan of the Cardigans, if you like Swedish pop from like the mid-90s, I mean, it's sort of alternative. It's got an edge to it, too. So, I mean, you decide how you want to see it. You can debate that in our chat room here on Twitch. If you are here live with us here on Twitch and not just watching a replay, first of all, hey, thanks for making the time. Second of all, good news, you're going to get a chance to win some stuff over the course of this hour as well. We've got prizes from Ernie Ball, and we've got some DLC for some codes for this DLC itself. So let's kick it off by looking at the Cardigans pack. That's this week's DLC. It's available on all platforms, and I don't know of any problems on any of those platforms. So it's a great week. Check this out, and we'll come back with our first song after this. Maybe one of those bands where you think like, oh, that song. Oh, I know that song. Right. So in any case, we have all of them right now for you. We're going to play all three of those on today's show. We've got a bonus song that we're going to throw in as well. But we are going to kick it off with Erase Rewind by the Cardigans featuring none other than Jason Kokel and Sharon Marmito. Hello, Jason Kokel and Sharon Marmito.
Hello.
That's Jason Kokel and Sharon Marmito, in case you're wondering. Thank you for both being here. It's always nice to see you.
You're welcome.
You're welcome.
Great. And your mics are working, which is even better.
Yes.
Jason, you did this note track, and I heard you playing this earlier today, and you were goofing around with it a little bit before we started. Just it's fresh in your mind. What jumps out at you about this one?
Well, the lead path has some keyboard parts in it that are slightly tricky, but I wanted something to differentiate lead from rhythm because there's just one guitar in the song. So I decided to add some of those bits in when they made sense. They're slightly hard, make it slightly harder to play, but they sound really cool when they're executed. And I think this song is deceptively trickier than.
This is what I heard from people this week. They're like, oh, you know, blah, 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 the Cardigans. That, you know, it's just not a band that people think of instantly when you think of, like, big guitar.
Yeah.
And yet people were like, oh, no, give it a try. You may be surprised. Like, the bass line on this is not simple at all, is it, Sharon? Oh, I'm sorry. It's simple for you. Other people were telling me, like, this is tricky. Like, this is trickier than you might immediately assume.
I definitely had to take it into Riff Repeater and slow it down a bit just to get the timing right. But I think... Yeah, once you do that, it's just the same groove sort of like all over.
It's easy, she says. It's easy. All right, well then let's give it a shot. Erase Rewind by the Cardigans, one of the three songs on this week's DLC pack from the Cardigans. And not only will you get a chance to win that a little bit later, but coming up right after the song, our first giveaway of Ernie Ball prizes.
Thank you.
Here I was saying that the bass line seemed kind of tricky, and you just nailed it like it was no thing at all.
I definitely like messed up a few times.
Somebody asked if there was a fuzz effect on the bass. Is there a fuzz effect on the bass?
No, that's a synthesizer. It's doubling the bass line that has that sort of buzzsaw synth sound. The bass itself is actually pretty muffled.
Okay.
It's like very, very muffled tone.
Oh,
so,
there you go.
But
Beatmaster 80, there's the answer. Excellent.
Yeah.
Anything else?
Fun. Yeah, fun little song.
Yeah, you get into the groove and it just kind of, it's fun to get
it's
in there.
Relaxing.
And those little pickup notes on the bass really do give it a lot of, the little hammer-on in the front of every phrase really gives it a lot of personality, a lot of feel.
Yeah, I had fun practicing this one for sure.
Cool.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Well, thank you both.
You're welcome.
Groovy, you're free to go. We're going to give some stuff away. What we've got is our first giveaway from Ernie Ball. If you like free things, now's a great time to pay attention because UbiVertigo will tell you what you need to do to enter everything that you see on your screen right now. We have a whole bunch of stuff that our friends at Ernie Ball graciously give us. Every week we have some of this stuff to give away. And everything that you see on the screen right now is what you're going to get. We've got brand new strings. Of course, Ernie Ball, very famous for its Slinky brand of strings. Regular Slinky strings for guitar, and then regular Slinky bass for your bass guitar. You are going to get a set of each. Doesn't matter. We don't care whether you play guitar or bass or both. We want you to be happy. And if you only play one of those instruments and you want to do something with the rest of those strings, make a friend. Give them something free. That's the best way to do it. We've also got a peg winder, which, again, most people know what this is. But if you're new to guitar, your fingers are going to start to hurt if you start twiddling all of the different the tuning pegs on your headstock over and over and over again. Why not just use a basic machine like a crank so that you can wind them cleanly and neatly? One of the things that you'll notice when you change your strings is that you really want the coil of the string to line up correctly and evenly, because you don't want it to like flop over on itself and stuff like that. So a peg winder will actually make that a heck of a lot easier. If you don't recognize what Wonder Wipes are, that's Ernie Ball's maintenance system. That's a way to keep your guitar minty fresh and beautiful and wonderful, and keep not only just grimy fingerprints off of everything, but also cleans your strings so that they last longer, so you don't have to change them quite as often. And then when you do change your strings, you should be conditioning the fretboard, because the oils naturally sort of leach out of the wood when you touch it and stuff. And so that's what that little packet is. It's a sampler pack, so you can get to try all three of those things, plus a brand new strap. At the moment, they are exactly what they are shown on the screen. They're black polypro nylon straps, so they are sort of good to have in your guitar case or in your gig bag. Even if you don't need a spare, a friend might, so always be considerate and bring one to them. And of course, picks. Everybody has them, everybody loves them, and everybody loses them. One of our friends here in the office who plays guitar, Julian, was like, I can't keep picks. And I'm like, here's some more. So you'll get a dozen from Ernie Ball, and then three of our very special pink Skullboy picks that you can only get here. We don't even offer them in the San Francisco lobby anymore. You can really just only get them here. In the lobby, we have a different pick, believe it or not. We found a stash of the older Rocksmith 1 black and gold picks, which is kind of great. You can only get these pink Skullboy picks here. And we have more of them now because they were so successful. I did reorder while I still had the budget to do so, because it's that time here where we're hit the end of our fiscal year and you go, oh gosh, how much money do I have left in my budget? I have to use it right away. So all that can be yours if you follow the instructions of our friend UbiVertigo. He is in the chat room. That's Doug. He's our community manager. And he's awesome for many reasons, but not least of which is he's the person who will be picking through Moobot the winner of that pack and all of our prizes today. And he will contact you through a whisper, because Twitch is sort of changing how they handle personal messages and whatnot. So if you win, he will contact you, and then he'll send the information to me, and then I will put boxes together for the Ernie Ball stuff if you're a winner. So if we have two of those to give away, one now, one a little bit later on. So if you don't win this first one, don't worry about it. You have more chances to win. If you're just joining us, welcome the man babbling incoherently here behind the podium. My name is Dan Amrick. I am the community manager on behalf of Rocksmith. And what we're doing this week is playing this week's DLC, this Cardigans song pack. is this week's DLC for Rocksmith. Something that took a couple people by surprise, but generally we saw a lot of people going, oh, cool. Like, you know, a generally positive response is, of course, what we always like to see. And we know that it won't always happen, but hopefully you're digging the tracks on this week. And if you're not too familiar with the band, well, this is your opportunity to become a little bit more familiar and see exactly what it is that these songs offer and what they may be able to teach you as you apply it to all other realms of your playing. And to show you that, it's Brian Podi here in the center square, and then Emmy Batista on the side on the Epiphone viola bass. Thank you for bringing that up. People have asked us about this. We had some. So if you didn't see Monday's encore, we did a Rocksmith encore all about bass, and very specifically, it turned out to be focused on acoustic bass. And Travis Kindred broke all that stuff down. So we have a replay you can watch. But somebody asked, how come you are, last time we played bass, they were like, how come you're playing short-scale bass music on full-scale basses? We're like, you can do whatever you want. But we happen to be playing a full-scale bass that time. And most of the other times we do the short-scale. This is a 30-inch scale bass. And it's this is technically the one that I take care of in the office, but I noticed that you have taken a real shine to it, and you like it too. What is it that you like about the bass so much? Is it the weight or the neck or
the weight, the neck, and my hands are small, so it feels better, feels more comfortable playing than the full scale. I've tried playing the full scale, and it's just like not as comfortable.
It is to
and
a certain
talks
extent.
To me.
Well, you know, if it speaks to you, I'm a big fan of the hippie. Like, if the guitar tells you that it's yours, man. You know, like I feel very strongly about Frank Zappa. Actually, is the one who said, if you walk into a guitar store and you pick up a guitar and it says "I'm yours," that's the guitar for you. Like, nothing else really matters because you can make whatever sounds you want. You can make whatever modifications. But if it doesn't feel right, it's not an instrument you're going to want to interact with. And I'm a big proponent of that. And that's why I have 20 guitars at home.
There you go.
Because they all spoke to me. That's the problem.
You hear a lot of voices, Dan.
I hear many voices in my head.
And they're very colorful.
Yeah. But then again, you built the guitar you're playing. You haven't shown this one on the stream for a while.
Yeah, it mostly lives up here. I grab it occasionally.
Do you have a name for this?
No.
Oh, okay. I didn't know if it was like, I mean, we all call them Podicasters for
right,
obvious reasons,
right.
But you hand-dyed this top and then you scalloped the fretboard.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Yeah.
A couple of the backstage pass people picked it up and went, oh, God, that's weird.
Yes, it is very weird. Scalloping a fretboard means that you carve away some of the wood in between each of the metal frets. It's a feel thing rather than anything else.
It's an Yngwie thing.
It's like, an Yngwie thing,
let's get to the root of the problem here.
Yngwie Malmsteen is a player known for playing very fast, very technical, very classical, neoclassical. Paganini stuff was his sort of like calling card. Mm-hmm. And so he scalloped the fretboard because he said that it let
like
him play faster.
Well,
right?
he did it because it was like a lute supposedly, and
right.
And that's was his original reason behind doing it. You know.
So you said I got to try it too.
Yeah.
Why
I've
not?
Done it on like three guitars.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay. But yeah, it's super weird if you're used to feeling wood underneath. If you're fretting, like if you play lead, it's a scalloped fretboard is probably a little bit more comfortable if you're moving very quickly.
Right, and if you play guitars that have like super jumbo frets on them anyway, it's not that different.
Oh, okay.
Because the frets are so big on some guitars that you're not going to touch the fingerboard anyway.
So a scalloped fretboard and a Floyd Rose were no doubt used on my favorite game by the Cardigans. Mm-hmm. I figure that's why you're doing it for purely authenticity reasons.
Yeah, and I forgot to bring up the guitar from my desk.
Oh, okay. Well, that's good, too. Well, I mean, we have others you could use. Yeah, but then
yeah,
again,
but
you know exactly what that is. You did the note track on this. Is there anything unusual, anything that you had to sort of... Kokel mentioned that he tracked some synth lines over to the lead as well. Did you wind up substituting instruments?
There's some real fuzzy stuff going on this one. It's been a while.
Okay.
To be perfectly honest.
Would you like to play it?
Yeah,
and then let's just play it then. This is my favorite game by the Cardigans.
I remember it having some really cool tones in it.
Well, let's hear what those could possibly be.
And Brendan was just here.
Oh, Brendan was just here. Brendan did stop by, but he didn't have time to stick around. Emmy's going to play bass, but she's going to play the song at 80% difficulty. Keep in mind that when we play here on the stream, we do everything at 100% difficulty, but when you play at home, Rocksmith is going to adjust to you.
Oh yeah, that's right.
I don't know what you're
that bass tone is epic.
Yeah.
That bass tone is just insane, and of course it's a very high gain bass tone, so yeah, that particular bass is like it was humming pretty hard. Radicore actually has a question for you, Pody. Are those scalloped frets pushing the note detection out? You seem to be missing a lot, and yet it sounds right. That's not part of this, is this?
We didn't calibrate.
Oh, that's probably it. So if you're not calibrating, don't forget to calibrate. In addition to tuning, you do have to set up Rocksmith so that it knows what guitars you're plugging into. We are playing kind of fast and loose here today.
Yeah. That first step of calibration sets your volume into note detection. So if that's off, it can affect what note detection's hearing.
Yeah, we were in a bit of a hurry today. We didn't get to do our full pre-flight check. Yeah. So that's probably more of what it is than the scalloped frets. The scalloped frets is really much more of a personal feel.
If you...
Oh, yeah, can we get some audio on the guitar?
Yeah, it's pretty easy to... If you press hard.
Oh, yeah.
Open D.
Oh, that's terrible.
Yeah, so you can throw it out pretty quick.
If you are looking for a closer look at those scalloped frets, I did sneak a photo while he was playing. So go to twitter.com/UbisoftStudioSF, and you can find a better, higher-res photo of what these scalloped frets look like from a three-quarter angle.
I should take some and throw them up on the Pody Guitars.
Yes, you should. Twitter.com/PodyGuitars is yours as well. Thank you both.
Thank you.
Thank you much. Hey, it's time for a video, and we said we were going to do the lessons video, right?
We did.
I sure hope we're going to. of course, a lot of people come to Rocksmith because it has so many of their favorite songs, the songs that make them, they hear it on the radio, or they hear it in a video, or in a movie trailer sometimes even, and they go, oh man, that really makes me want to learn how to play that song. And we get that. But of course, in order to get to the point where you can play anything that you want to play, it helps to take lessons. And we have lessons within Rocksmith. A lot of people sort of just hang out in the learn a song area because that's what motivates them the most. But you will notice that after you're done playing a song, it'll be like, hey, you should take this lesson. You should take that lesson. You should take this lesson. And yet, I wonder how many of you actually have. So here's a quick trailer to explain what our lesson system is, how it's structured, what it's intended to do. And take a look at that. We'll be back with a bonus song, and then we'll start taking some of your questions after this. So thanks for being here. This is the Rocksmith Live developer stream, and we will be right back after this.
Rocksmith is designed to be a top-to-bottom guitar learning experience. We've got great ways for you to learn songs, but at some point we have to show you how to play bends, how to play the slides, how to play these basic things that you're going to play in all the songs. So that's what lessons are for. We wanted the experience with lessons to be very personal. If you're just starting guitar, then you'll be able to get instructions on how to hold it, how to put on your strap, how to play a single note. If you're a pretty advanced guitarist, then you'll be able to learn really advanced techniques like tapping and pinch harmonics. With Rocksmith 1, we really just scratched the surface with a basic introduction to a basic technique. With Rocksmith 2014, we really wanted to break things down more from the very beginning to very advanced applications of each technique. There are more than 80 lessons covering topics for guitar and bass and extra things like tuning and alternate tunings and how to take care of your equipment. We really wanted to boost up the feeling of interactivity with the lessons this time around. So you're not just watching a video and then parroting what you see in the video and then you're on your own. You are watching a video to get the basics, and then we're going to listen to you play and we're going to give you instant feedback about how you're doing. We're not just saying you did it wrong, we're saying here's what you need to do to fix what you're doing wrong. I get to see a knowledgeable player actually playing the technique correctly. So here's a note and I'm going to try to play it.
I think you're on the wrong string there.
So it's not just telling me I'm wrong, it's saying, oh, you're on the wrong string. Well, let me get on the right string.
You don't need to bend it quite that far. You've got the right idea.
So it's telling me not just that I'm doing something wrong, it's telling me what I need to do to correct my technique. Okay, so right string, right fret, right place. Let's bend it the right amount.
Yeah, that was good.
And I go on to the next video. We also felt it was really important to present each technique in a musical context. Every lesson comes with a practice track that teaches you how to play that technique in the course of a song. You're always in control. You can skip ahead, skip back, replay a section, replay a video, replay one of the riffs. With lessons in Rocksmith 2014, you're not just learning to play a game, you're learning to play music.
Hi everybody, my name's Dan Amrick and I'm tuning a guitar. And you can't tell because I'm totally professional. You have just stumbled into the Rocksmith live stream, and this is where we put the live into live stream, kids. This is where it happens, and I'm going to play on this next song. So first of all, apologies for that. Second of all, it is, as we were talking before, it's important to calibrate your guitar. So we just calibrated our guitars, and then we tuned them, and we're checking all that stuff before we play this song. This is David Stevens. You may recognize him as our QA lead. He's the QA supervisor.
Sure.
He supervises the Qs and the As.
Yep.
He is the last line of defense between bugs and you. Thankfully, his job is super easy because we just don't make any mistakes ever. sure, let's see if they are they going to go. I'm looking
let's
over.
Let's go with that.
Oh yeah, chat says absolutely right, Dan, you're correct. Okay, thanks. I appreciate that, Twitch. Hopefully right now you are busy still entering or have just entered a contest that we're running where you can get the DLC. We're giving away 5 Steam codes for the DLC for the Cardigans pack, which is this week's DLC. We're going to play all 3 of those songs. We've done 2 of those songs as is. And we're going to actually play a second song, a bonus song now, in between, and then we'll do some Q&A. So if you have some Q&A for the QA guy, write in your cues, and we'll try to generate the A's when we're done this song. But when I was looking at the Cardigans output and the time that it came out, and I always try to find something that's in our library that is compatible, something that makes a certain amount of sense, maybe something that you would have heard on the radio at the same time or is in a similar genre or has some relation. Sometimes I like to get kind of fancy where I'll be like, oh, this band opened for that band, or this band is a huge influence on this other band, stuff like that, so you can see how it all goes together. Only Happy When It Rains by Garbage is one of my favorite songs from the mid-90s, and that's when a lot of the Cardigan stuff was too, so I figured, like, why the hell not? And then even more, I decided not to play bass just because I wanted something super easy, and this was relatively easy, but I do like playing rhythm guitar. I still consider myself a rhythm guitarist. I only ever seem to play bass on the stream, so I figured I would do it too. And you picked up on lead right away. You were like, sure, why not? Yeah.
Incidentally, this song has some of the best bass tones in the game.
So you're saying I made a mistake.
Well,
damn it. You want me to...
You can never go wrong.
Well, I can never go back,
something
too.
Something like this.
Damn it, I'm sorry. If we had talked about that ahead of time, it has great guitar tones, too. It does,
it
but
does.
Yeah. Like, well, now I feel... Well, I've screwed up, and now I'll screw up some more. So, yeah, Only Happy When It Rains is available as part of a 3-song pack from Garbage, or you can just buy it individually if you'd like. And if you don't know the song by the title, well, why don't we just play it so that you can figure out, oh, yeah, it's that song, too. So this is just a bonus song for funsies so that we can fill out the hour or so that we go when we stream. And after this, we will handle some Q&A. I have some questions that have already been asked up to this point in the... Wow. I'm only happy when it rains. I'm only happy when it's complicated. That tone is huge.
Pour your misery down on me. Pour your misery down on me.
that is like a Mack truck giant guitar tone on the rhythm thing. And of course, the partial chords, when it comes in and gets interesting, that is what I totally screwed up.
It's a whole different tone there, too.
It is, and it was unforgiving because I was like, oh, I did this while I was practicing this inverted. yeah, so that sort of does confuse one when one is trying to play things right and not. Oh, look, who just walked in? It's Brian McCune. Brian McCune, would you like to take my spot here? And that way, maybe you can join us for the Q&A. Sure. He's nodding silently as good studio guests often do. Now is the time that we will actually take some of your questions. As I mentioned, we actually have one left over from the encore that was the other day with Travis Kindred. I have a bass question that I promised I would answer. Come on in, Brian. The water's fine. Hi, Brian. Of course, as you've been asking questions throughout the show, our friend Doug, UB Vertigo, has been cutting and pasting and noting those for me. So I will get through as many as I can for the time that I have. And thank you, David. That was fun. I would have done the bass if I had known I was going to screw up the guitar that bad. The one left over from Encore is from Megatony YT, and he says, I have a technical question specifically to playing Rocksmith on bass. I find that I have issues with tuning and sustain on the low E, and it's exacerbated with lower tunings. Is this my PC just not able to sample quickly enough at those super low frequencies? It's kind of just endemic to the lower we go, the harder it is for the software to detect it. It's not necessarily your PC, but it could be how you have your bass set up if you're not in perfect intonation. Can we get Mr.
Thank
Brian?
Thank you. Yeah, hi. I was going to say, hello. I was going to say, my first gut instinct was to check your output. It was like, do you have active pickups or not? And do you have one of those bass boosters? Because the lower you go with all that oomph, it can actually distort.
Does it get muddy when you have an active signal?
Yeah, it could just make the output too high to detect. So that could be an issue. And that becomes an issue on the lower strings.
Calibration, yes.
Calibration. So that's step
the word
one.
Of the day. Today's word.
Also, just check how hard you're plucking the string, because on the lowest string, if you're playing really hard, and especially in lower tunings, it'll go bow.
Yeah, so it doesn't take much pressure to really get that string going. You know, it's that big thick string, and it's kind of floppy. You know, you just got to brush it.
Yeah, fair enough. Okay, thank you. This one's a good one. Embolism 1982 says, without getting anybody into trouble, do you guys have any songs that you've ported into the game just for fun? Maybe one of the note trackers just had some time and a song got stuck in their head and they wanted to do it.
No, but I think that's a totally fair question, because that's crossed my mind as like a thing.
Like, you know what I'd like to do for fun? More work.
More of the work that I do.
The only songs that I know of that have been transcribed and note-tracked were ones in the very early days that were proof of concept. Like,
a handful of songs
to say, this is how the system will work. This is what we're looking at doing.
Yeah, that's ancient history.
Yeah,
though.
But
we're
like
talking 8 years
eight years ago. Yeah. Like, there were songs that still have not appeared in the game because they were simply test beds and they were not intended for release.
I actually note-tracked songs that never saw the light of day when I first started. And that was actually a common occurrence during Rocksmith 1 development while we were proving out level design and also things like, is this fun to play? There were popular songs by popular bands that when we took them to the playtest stage, when we used to playtest down in the garage, and Paul would be like, okay, I'm bored at this point.
Oh,
this
God, you guys did playtesting in the garage?
Yeah, yeah.
It's and then just storage room now, so I didn't know.
Yeah. Those were some... It really felt like a indie studio startup vibe back then. I played ping pong with Jake Parks, the original engineer who like designed all of the engineering tech that became Rocksmith.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Makoto Fatora says, speaking of calibrating, because it is the word of the day, when I calibrate, I get about 50 volume level changed, resetting gain to default, and calibrating takes an hour. Why is it doing that, and is there a way around that?
That seems highly uncommon to me, but
yeah, I can't say I've ever seen that.
Okay.
As someone who's seen it all.
I was going to say, it's his job to see it all.
If you can cap a video of it and send it our way, I'd love to see it.
Yeah.
What platform are you playing on? Help give us information.
As many details as humanly possible.
I have threatened that I'm going to get shirts for the community Rocksmith team that just say, what platform are you on? Because so many people go, this thing isn't working. And that's the sole like content of the tweet is that well, you know, it might be a completely different reason on PC than it is on a console, or you know, like we see different behaviors, little kind of things here and there, and there are different tricks that you can do. Like there's a way to reduce latency on PS4 using a little external USB sound device that doesn't necessarily work on Xbox One. So like, yeah, fix your thing. And but we don't know what thing you're using. We're on 7 platforms now. It's
info about
insane.
Your guitar would be great too.
Yeah, so please, yeah, send that in. You can either post it in our support area at rocksmith.com in the forums, or again, just shooting a little video with your phone of what's happening is super useful. Whenever our engineers and our bug testers can get video to see what you see, that skips a lot of the Q&A portion of the affair, and we can actually get right down to, oh, this is what it is, or this is what we think it is, or this is what we should investigate. So you can also send it in on Twitter. You can just, you know, at Ubisoft Studio SF or at Rocksmith Game with the video, if that's the easiest way to do it. However you can do it, send it to us. And thank you for bringing it up, because that's good. Marcus Coble says, is the equipment in the back real? Real as a heart attack. The nice thing about being a partner with people like Marshall and Eden is that we do have some actual real Marshall and Eden gear here in the office. And this is some of the gear that we used for the Rocksmith Live show. Like, just to prove that it's real, we had a whole bunch of gear on stage that day. But we did use some of the primarily we used some of the and Pody believes that the only way to get proper tone is to take real 100-watt amps and just crank the hell out of them. Pody had his JCM-800 on there. We had the Office JCM-800. I think we brought the Mode 4. And I don't know if we brought the Plexi, because the Plexi is totally like, you have to turn that thing up ridiculously loud. And everybody running the board is like, yes, do that more often. But yes, it's absolutely real. There was a time when people were not working super hyper late. Now seems like everybody's, I'm never the last one out of the office anymore. But there have been times that, you know, like on Friday afternoons that we would turn on the amps and we would actually have jam sessions. We're all too busy now to do it, I suppose. But and we have, you know, the South Park team, so we don't want to bother the South Park team while they're working on that DLC that you love so much. You know, it's like, what the hell? Why are they suddenly cranking all the amps? Yeah. So yeah, it's real and it's spectacular. Let me see if I have anything else. That's a good one. A question for David Penicillin Stevens, who is our last line of defense.
Ironically, I'm allergic to penicillin.
When is the exclusive full-screen beta patch that came out in January of last year going live to the full game? This is a good point. This is more of a Peter Mac question, because Peter was really driving the implementation of that.
So that was an interesting problem with the Windows 10 update that happened in, I want to say, end of August, early September. It was actually Windows that caused the issue, but we wanted to not only circumvent it if it was still occurring for people, but put in a way to have windowed full screen, because who doesn't love that? And we're working on it. Yeah, we're actually in the middle of working on it right now.
Yeah, that is not an abandoned thing. We did hit a snag after we did that beta where we had some shifts internally where it was like, oh, we need to take resources and put it on this other thing. So it wasn't forgotten, but we did not say anything about it, because I've been waiting for good news to give you and say like, oh, by the way, this is happening. But yeah, that's back on the front burner. So thank you for your patience, and thank you for your memory, and thank you for testing out the beta, because obviously you're one of the people that gave it a shot and helped us out with that. So appreciate it. I think that's pretty much all we have more questions, and I will answer them in the chat room while we do our next song, but I do want to get on and get out of here on time this week for once, because people have other things to do. As I've said, we're very, very busy. If you please do stick around. If your question was not answered, I'll give a shot at doing it, and I'll write to you directly here in the chat room. And also, if you have other questions, you can ask them through other means. You don't have to just wait for us to be live every week on Twitch to do this. You can write to us on Twitter, at RocksmithGame is a good way to do it. We do have a Facebook page, and Doug and I are actually pretty diligent about keeping track of that. Tawny as well, Black Widow 9, also helps us answer some of the posts and comments that we get on Facebook. So facebook.com/rocksmith will take you just right where you want to go. And, of course, rocksmith.com in the forums Click on the little chat bubbles at the top of our homepage, and that'll take you straight there. So we'll try to answer your questions whenever we can. We care. We love knowing that you care enough to ask us questions like that. But I'll get to the rest of those after this next song, which features the aforementioned Brian McCune, who was slightly more than a prop. He's our manager of musical content, and he's staring down Sam Schwartz. And I don't know, are you guys having a moment, or should I leave you?
Oh, we're having several moments.
It's a little too.
Why do birds suddenly appear?
That is not confirmed.
Not confirmed. DLC. Not a DLC. Yeah.
Yeah, we can't see anything. Like,
I've had it up to here with the DLC confirmed.
Well,
jokes.
Today on social media, we found a fun article that detailed all the different times that like big heavy rockers and classic rockers have interacted with the Muppets, and we just thought that was like fun. So it was like 31 times the Muppets hung out with rock stars. And sure enough, the first comment on Facebook is like, Muppets confirmed! And I'm like, Muppets not confirmed. Can we just enjoy stuff together? Like, everything is not a cryptic DLC hint. And furthermore, if you want the Muppets, we're open to that idea, but you do have to go through the request page at rocksmith.com. It just gets very tiring because people think they are the funniest person in the world and ha, 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 ha. No, just, you know, stop. We just want to have fun with you guys sometimes and have cool discussions and have these sort of like mutual touchstones that we've all experienced. Oh, I know the Muppets. Oh, I know Alice Cooper. They were together once. Let's talk about that. That's fun. And it doesn't mean that either artist is necessarily on the docket. But, you know, we're still open to your ideas. Just chill out. Soapbox is done.
Good.
Hold on.
I feel clean.
Oh, there we go. I stepped off of the soapbox now.
I feel cleaner.
You guys are going to do our final song, which is from this week's DLC pack from the Cardigans. And this is the one that I think probably is the big hit single.
It is. It's a big one.
It is Love
it's
Fool.
It's a giant one.
Yeah. And this was in Romeo and Juliet? Was this in the Baz Luhrmann Romeo and Juliet?
It was.
You don't know.
It absolutely was.
I'm sure it was.
It totally could have been.
But please don't be. Don't let that be the question. Like, all right, this is the one that makes it so the pit either falls under you or does, you know, like.
No. It was not a pass fail.
It was a big. There are a few film soundtracks. Not talking about film scores, but soundtracks of licensed music like Guardians of the Galaxy. Romeo and Juliet, the soundtrack was a big one. Had stuff from Garbage as well and Radiohead. Mm. I feel like talk show host Radiohead track was the thing that opened up. It's the first shot of Romeo. Anyway, this was a big song, big album from like 95, 96. Seminal. I talk often about what I call like zeitgeist songs, songs that can put you specifically back in a certain year and time. And I feel like Love Fool is one of those songs.
Me too.
The Cranberry Zombie is another classic example. It's like when you hear that, you just, it's like you were wearing the flannel again.
Wherever you were in 1996.
Love Fool is definitely one of those like time capsule songs.
It's funny you mention the Cranberries because that's the band that I always got the Cardigans mixed up with. Two bands that start with C, and they were both out at the same time, even though their music is
actually
different.
My wife said the same thing. Because I was telling her, I was like, sweetheart, we're doing the Cardigans pack. I was telling her because we're doing Loveful, and she was like, that song isn't the same one that does Zombie or whatever. Like, she was getting all confused, and I was like, no, like, that's not right. And she's
Because this one is called Loveful, and the word fool features heavily in the lyrics of Linger by the Cranberries. That's where my brain short circuits and crosses over. And I always think, and so I started singing this, and my wife was like, that's the Cranberries. What are you talking about? I'm like, oh my God, you're right. Maybe you don't recognize Love Fool from its title, or maybe you think you recognize Love Fool from its title, but now we're going to play it. So now you can go, oh, that song is Love Fool. Of course it is.
We're all probably wrong. Yeah.
Like let's play it. It's Love Fool by the Cardigans, one of the three songs in this week's Cardigans Song Pack.
I don't think I calibrated, but that's okay.
We'll be fine.
I only have P90s.
Oh, yeah, you're only going to just set this on fire. That's fine. You can buy this song individually, or you can get all three as a pack for a slight discount. And we'll give away more stuff.
Yeah, it didn't pick me up at all. I'm plugged in. Hold on. Okay, I'm good now.
Yeah.
Didn't pick that up. Pony, I'm not getting anything.
That's
nothing.
Yeah, not a sausage.
No.
There we go. Is it your jack?
Maybe. All right, let's try that again. This is for me. This is for me and my guitar that probably needs a little love.
Could have played the same Vincent. You need Wonder Wipes. Look at all the fingerprints on that.
I know.
And we're going to calibrate. While they calibrate, you hear the awesome sound of calibration.
Can you calibrate for real?
Calibrate for real. Oh, right. Really? Is that how you calibrate? With a slab?
Sometimes.
Oh, wow.
It just wants to see how, like, it's setting your noise gate, right?
Sure. After this song, we will do our second Ernie Ball giveaway. So if you were looking for maybe some new strings or some extra picks or maybe even a bonus strap to carry in your gig bag, you're going to have the opportunity to win that right after we do this song. So stick around, and thanks for being here.
It's Pody approved.
And I'm gonna,
as long as we're Pody approved.
Sorry we didn't calibrate. I should have paid attention.
It's the importance.
Now I can hear my guitar.
Whoa. Huge difference.
Yeah. Very nice. And what a difference calibration made. I was able to hear both of your parts very, very clearly. Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you both very much.
Yeah, that was fun.
Oh, dude. Sam, do you have any other insight into... Oh, well, you know what? Never mind your insight.
Yeah. Okay. You know what?
Because
today's a special day.
It's Sam's birthday.
Man.
And
turn the lights down if you can.
To you. Everybody in your own key. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Sam Shorts.
Happy birthday to you.
We did not tell Sam about this.
Thank you guys so much.
Just pass.
Oh, wonderful.
Yeah, hey, that's great. Why not take a $2,000 base and put a cake on it?
Okay,
put a cake on it. Not a lie, right there. Thank you for doing that. And happy birthday, Sam. You're
thank you so much.
You're 19 now, right?
Just about.
Yeah, just about 19. Good for you.
18 and 4/4.
All right. Fantastic.
Yeah. I'm old. It's good.
It was great to see
thank you guys.
The
so
honest
much.
Surprise on your face. That was
great. I was like, they're gonna do something. They're gonna, and it was in the back of my head, and I was like, I wonder if they're gonna do something today.
Obviously, the chat also wishes you a happy birthday across the board.
Yeah, we all hope it's the best year yet of your life.
So far, they've been getting better and better. Ever since I started working here, things have been going pretty well. Yeah. So.
Well, then we shouldn't fire you today, I guess.
Wait till at least tomorrow.
You know what I'd love to give you for a birthday present?
Not a pink slip?
No, not a pink slip, but an Ernie Ball prize pack. But I can't because it's going to go to somebody else. So in honor of Sam's birthday, somebody's going to win everything that you're about to see on the
Somebody's going to get my
King
prize
of
pack.
Segways.
Prize
pack. More of Court Jester of Segways, I think. The Ernie Ball prize pack is filled with goodies that any guitarist or bassist can use and would probably like, because we've noticed that guitarists tend to use guitar strings. So we asked Ernie Ball for a set of those, the regular slinky strings. We've noticed that bass guitarists tend to prefer putting bass guitar strings on their bass guitars. So we also got a package of those. And of course, you don't have to change those nearly as often, but you do have to change them eventually. And probably if you're currently a bassist, the time to change your bass strings is when you get a free set. Also, a brand new peg winder to make the string changes a little bit easier. The Wonder Wipe system to keep your guitar clean and your strings clean so that you don't have to change them as often. Plus a brand new strap, 12 picks from our friends at Ernie Ball, plus three of our very super exclusive 1337 pink Skullboy picks. You can only get these picks here. We'll send you three of them. Please do use them. They are intended to be used. They are 0.88 millimeters, so they're sort of a medium heavy, which seems like a nice compromise. And these have been extremely popular both around the office and outside of the office. People really dig this design. So with that in mind, if you would like to win this, pay attention to what our friend Ubi Vertigo, Doug RCM in the chat room, is talking to you about right now. He will give you the only parameters that you really need. There's very few things that you have to do to win this. If you win, he will contact you via Whisper here on Twitch. He's going to ask you for your name, your address, and your phone number. Please give him those things so that he can give them to me, and then I can put a box together with those prizes. I physically have the prizes here in our highly guarded storage closet in the Rocksmith compound, and then I will send them out to you as soon as I possibly can. Those of you who have won and are outside of America, good news. Yes, you can also win. Some people ask sometimes, oh, is this America only? No, it's not. We ship prizes wherever they will let us ship it. The only country we've had problems shipping to is Russia. Sorry. But we've sent them to Brazil, to Australia, to Scotland, all kinds of places. If you are waiting on an international package, a bunch of them just went out. We had some problems with our mail software, so I asked the mailroom, and they followed up with me this week, and they said, good news, those three that were sticking around from previous winners, they finally went out. So good news, and check your mailboxes soon. But that's courtesy of Ernie Ball, and thank you to Ernie Ball, obviously, for giving us all the free stuff that we can pass on to you. If you missed some of the free codes that we gave away at the halfway point of the show, and you'd still like, now you've heard all the Cardigan songs, and you're like, you know what, I would like that, but I'm very cheap, and I don't want to pay. Well, that's great. If you go to the Reddit group for Rocksmith, reddit.com/r/rocksmith, we'll be giving away some there tomorrow. And also on Twitter, on the Studios account, so twitter.com/UbisoftStudioSF, we will give away five throughout the course of the day. And they'll just be sort of at random times. You won't know when they show up. But they will be spaced out so that those of you who are in different time zones and different places in the world may have a better chance at getting one versus another. So we want to keep giving you free stuff so that you keep playing. We know that that's the goal to getting better is to keep playing your guitar, and we want to give you as many reasons to do that as possible. That includes fresh DLC every week. What's coming next week? I'm glad you asked, because you know I'm not going to tell you. Next week, we actually have a fun artist, something I'm looking forward to. That doesn't mean anything whatsoever. Some people have tried to look into that and be like, oh, what are Dan's favorite bands? No, no, no. I have a pretty wide appreciation of music. But if you would like to get a concrete clue and confirmation of what's going on next week, you can find that tomorrow in our forums at rocksmith.com. Go to the DLC area. Our friend, the aforementioned UB Vertigo, will be posting a clue written and created by Rolling Stone 222, one of the people in our forums, who's just so good at solving the puzzles that I used to make that he talked himself into a thankless job of actually creating more puzzles and more clues. So work with your fellow forum followers tomorrow morning. Check out what's going on. See if you can decipher his clue, and you'll be on the very first tip to find out what next week's DLC is. The rest of you, if you don't want to do that or if you don't have time to do that, check our social media feeds on Sunday. That will be your first clue. And then we'll confirm for reals on Monday before it comes out on Tuesday. So we've got, you know, like between that and playing guitar, there's all kinds of stuff that you can do with Rocksmith over the weekend. I'm going to actually, I think, go to the movies and play some D&D this weekend. So I hope you have an enjoyable one as well. On behalf of myself, Dan Amrick, your community developer, and all of the Note Trackers here at Studio San Francisco, thanks for tuning in. Really appreciate that you've made time in your schedule to come hang out with us. And if you're watching a replay, that's just as good. Unfortunately, I don't have any other freebies except for the aforementioned ones that you can probably get tomorrow. We're going to leave you with another look at the Cardigans. This is our three-song pack for this week, and it has a lovely trailer thanks to Chris Wu and the Creative Services team. So bask in its glory, and then we will see you here next week, Thursday, 3 p.m. Pacific, 6 p.m. Eastern, 10 p.m. UTC for whatever next week's mystery DLC pack might be. Join us next week, and we'll play it for you live. Thanks, everybody. Bye.